Alhamdulillah, we are lucky. Allah, I'm lucky to be back to the Bay Area with the Ahbab of Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to celebrate the Rabi' with all of you. Our Habib Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is chosen by Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala chose for him when he told him, إِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا, you are in my eye. Allah chose for him the best time to bring him on earth, because earth, Allah hated all earth, and Rasulullah came and fixed it. From the worst time to the best generation, his time. خير القرون قرني ثم الذي ثم الذي لي. Allah chose for him the best place, Mecca and then Medina. Medina used to be a city that everybody ran away from diseases and fighting and became Medina Munawwara. All our hearts goes to Medina. All of us, and even some of the poem this, they say, we're in paradise, we say, oh Medina. Allah chose for him the best hearts after prophets. Allah chose the best hearts to be the companion of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah chose for him the best woman.
Assalamu alaikum, everybody. So we have a young man, 2 years old. His name is Amar. He's missing. I think he's in the Sunday school area. So if you hear me and there's a 2-year-old boy named Amar, go ahead and bring him to the office. His parents are there. Amar, he's 2 years old. He has a striped shirt on. Jazakallah khair.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the best heart to be the companion of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And chose the best wife at the beginning, Sayyidah Khadija, to take a good care of him. To take a good care of him. When she asked him, Ya Rasulullah, when she asked him, Ya Muhammad, who was the Prophet at the time, she said, if you are the Messenger of Allah, if you're going to be the Messenger of Allah, take care of me. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Oh Khadija, if I am the Prophet that you're saying I'll be the Prophet, don't worry. But if I'm not, then the God of the Prophet that you think he sent, he will never let you down. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took care of Rasulullah from all aspects. Allah told him to read. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. So first the order came to read. He cannot read. Then it came to his heart. And then Allah told him, سنقرئك فلا تنسى. You will read, I will never forget. Don't worry about it. And he starts saying the Quran quickly. And Allah told him, لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به. Don't rush. إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه. We're going to gather it and we'll give it to you. Don't worry about it. And Allah told us that وأنزل الله عليك الكتاب والحكمة وعلمك ما لم تكن تعلم. That Allah gave you the book. And the hikmah is the whatever is Rasulullah is saying, because ما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو لوحي يوحى. And Allah told us that he gave him knowledge that never been given before. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared everything in him. His hearing, his eye, his intellect, his understanding, his body. He gave him from everything, all aspect, the highest, the maximum. That's why he said, I hear what you don't hear. And I see what you don't see. I spend my night with Allah. He feeds me and give me drink. Then when it came to his heart, where Allah put the best heart ever, that there is no heart like him, in his chest. And he filled it with rahmah. And he said, this is rahmah lil alameen. And alameen is everything except Allah. Everything is alameen except Allah. Then, in this heart, all the light is in it. And all the mercy is in it. So Allah first wanted to show the whole creation the light of the Habib Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's why Sayyidina Jibreel came and he opened his chest. He allowed the inner heart to give the light to all creation. That light shine on everything. And then there is in the heart, There is a rahmah for all creation, right? And also there is rahmah for shaitan. But Allah said there is no rahmah for shaitan. So Sayyidina Jibreel took that portion in his heart, that mercy that goes to shaitan, took it away in order he will not receive rahmah from that. Even though on the day of judgment, there is amazing hadith that Sayyidina Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his servant Barira came to him, and she was walking, a man, his name is not mentioned, and he told her, oh, your hair is showing. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam will not benefit you on the day of judgment. You have to cover yourself. She got angry. She went to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and said, that's what he's saying. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he really got angry. And he took his thawb like this, and his face is red. And the Sahaba then knew, whenever they see this movement and the face is red, that there's something serious. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, they took their swords. Whatever you want, we're fighting with you. He went to the minbar, he said, what's wrong with people? They think that I'm not going to benefit my family. He said, I'll be giving shafa'ah, and shafa'ah that goes from here to Yemen. And then he said, on the day of judgment, I'll give shafa'ah. Until the people I give shafa'ah, they give shafa'ah. And until the shaitan will put his head up, thinking that he will receive the shafa'ah. But that mercy went taken away from him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for all the stages in the life. Prepared him when he was young. Then whenever there is a music happening or something happening, he will sleep. He will never attend something that, you know. And they prepared him. Allah told us, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. If this Quran came on a mountain, it will be crushed. And then Allah told us, وَأَنْزَلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. He made his heart ready to receive the Quran and filter it out for us so we can hear it. If it came directly to Rasulullah on his tongue, we would be crushed, all of us. But from his heart, received, and he were able to pass it to us on his blessed tongue. And Allah prepared him for the barzakh. Because he said, حياتي خير لكم ومماتي خير لكم. My life is good for you. Whatever you do, Allah will fix it in the revelation. And mamati, when I die, it's all good for you. Because your action will be presented to me. When I find something good, I thank Allah on your behalf. And who is he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He's Ahmad, Muhammad, Mahmoud. He's the owner of Iwar al-Hamd. The banner of Hamd in his hand. And he's doing Hamd on our action. Imagine you did something. You read just one verse of Quran or you pray two rak'ah. That's your action. And you were thinking about, you know, this dish or this business. But that action will go to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam will filter it and wrap it with his hamd. And Allah will receive your action with the hamd of his Habib Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And Allah will grow that. Until, as mentioned, that on the Day of Judgment, you will look at the action, say, whose prophet, whose action this is, whose prophet? They say, no, this is your action. Being received from Allah, from the Habib Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with his hamd. And he said, if I find something else, I'll do istighfar on your behalf. And Allah told us, the istighfar is accepted. Whenever he did istighfar, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is accepted. Then Allah prepared him for the biggest mawlid ever. We celebrate mawlid here, 2-3 hours. The biggest mawlid is 50,000 years. Allah made the whole creation in a need for help. And they go from prophet to prophet, prophet till they get to Rasulullah Sallam. Say, Rasulullah, we need your help. He said, Ana laha. I'm designed for it. Allah designed me for this moment. Allah designed me for this. And he will do sajda. And the sajda, because he is the owner of banner of the Hamd, he is in the Maqam al-Mahmud. His name is Ahmad Muhammad Mahmud, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah will give him Muhammad, a type of Hamd in the sujood that never heard before. The whole creation will be amused by the Muhammad of Rasulullah, where the anger of Allah will go down and the mercy will go up. And Allah will tell him, what do you want? He said, Ya Allah, ummati, my ummah, all of you. So I wanted all of you. He said, we'll give you your ummah. What do you want? He said, Ya Allah, just let us pass from the Day of Judgment, these 50,000 years, to the courtyard. And then Allah prepared them also with two overflow from paradise to a place from the Kawthar. They were overflow from Kawthar to Al-Hawd, the water pool. His Hawd, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is ready for us. And he told us, he was on the minbar, he told the Sahaba, مَوْعِدُنَا Al-Hawd. We have appointment. All of you, you have appointment with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the Hawd. And one of you, he told me, he said, when you wake, when you grow, go up from your grave, rush to the appointment. Don't look for your brother or mother or wife, or rush to the appointment of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he said, مَوْعِدَ الْحَوْدِ. We have appointment with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah prepared him for what? For the sirat, and the mizan, and the accounting. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will never let us down. At all. Then paradise cannot open except to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will knock on the door of paradise, and the owner of paradise, he will say, Narudwan, he will say, I am only allowed to open for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, with his ummah. We are the first one to enter paradise. And people of paradise, there are 80 rows. Sorry, 120 rows. The old paradise. 80 of them, this ummah. Two-thirds. Because of the barakah of Rasulullah sallam. And then, Allah prepared them for what? In the Firdaus al-A'la. In all the paradise, he will be there, shining his light. And then, on top of all of this, Allah gave him al-mar'u ma' man ahab. That the one who loved Rasulullah sallam will be with him. This is for us. Al-mar'u ma' man ahab. The one who loves Rasulullah sallam will be with him. And he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knew what the meaning of loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he is with Allah. And whoever from us loves Rasulullah sallam, we are with Rasulullah sallam, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the highest pleasure in paradise, which is al-hadra al-ilahiyya, with Rasulullah sallam. The best thing to see Allah with the lenses of Rasulullah ﷺ. So the best thing to do is connect your heart to the heart of Rasulullah ﷺ. He will connect you directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the easiest thing in our life, to get the highest maqam, the highest position with Allah, is through loving Rasulullah ﷺ and doing salat on Rasulullah ﷺ. And as our shaykh, they said, the minimum you do at salawat every day is 300. Because the minimum of a lot is 300. Allah said, اذكروني ذكرا كثيرا. Mention me a lot. The minimum of a lot is 300. If you keep on doing this, your name is mentioned in front of Rasulullah sallam. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is giving you salam back. And his salam back and his salah on you is the best thing in this world. We gain this. It's us. This ummah. All other nations, they wish to be in our shoes. Everybody. So this has nothing to do with our action. If we have sins, if we have things, problem, an issue, he says, shafa'ati li ahl kaba'ir min ummati. My shafa'ati with the big sins of my ummah, the kaba'ir. He said, ni'mi al-abdu ana li shirari ummati. What a good ni'mah for the evil of my ummah. So how about the lovers of Rasulullah? All of you will be with Rasulullah. You will see what a big ni'mah, because they say the best ni'mah ever is to recognize the ni'mah. And just recognizing the blessing that we have in Rabi', because of that coming of Rasulullah to us and to be our prophet, and we are his ummah, this is the highest ni'mah. And I know it's time for Isha, inshallah. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.